Okay, about to brew some Oktoberfest beer. So I got everything laid out. I've got my my dry malt extract, DME. Got my two kinds of hops. I've got my yeast. Got my yeast nutrient. I've got my Werflock tablets. You can also use Irish moss. Got the guidebook that when I when I took the class. Got some iodine. Got the recipe. This is not actually the recipe. I'm substituting all this stuff for the Oktoberfest recipe, but it's got some really good guidance on how to do it all. So I'm just going to follow that with the other recipe. Got a funnel. Got most of my tools right here. Got some water I'm about to put in this 20-liter pot. We're going to get that boiling here in a second. And here in the fridge, I've got 3 more gallons chilling. I'm about to get the cooler.
Okay, so we're going to put 3 gallons of water in the 20-liter kettle and get that going.
Okay, let's start boiling some water. There we go. Okay, just gonna put a lid on there to contain the heat and turned on the fan. Okay, the recipe I'm using calls for some steeping grains, so I've milled these at the homebrew mart, and we're gonna put it in this cloth bag and seal it up with some string. Here's a look at the milled grain there. There we go. So that's 1 pound right there. Okay, you got everything in the bag. Got a knot on the top. I actually tied an extra knot with string too. Keep it all together, ready to steep when it's time to do it. Okay, gonna add a thermometer. We're gonna bring the water up to 160 degrees so we can steep. Okay, looks like we're getting there at 130 right now. Okay, while we're waiting for the water to get up to 160 degrees, I went to the side of the house and got the cooler. And this is what we're gonna cool the wort off with before we add the yeast. There we go. So steeping grain is going in. We're at 160 degrees. So we wanna retain a heat about 155 degrees. I'm just gonna kind of stir things around here to maximize exposure to the grain. I'm not really squishing it, I'm just kind of moving it around.
You have 28 minutes left on your 30-minute timer.
Okay, we're gonna steep that for 30 minutes. Okay, we're gonna get all our hop additions ready. Okay, first thing are the hops, 1 ounce of each. Yeah, so this recipe will have 1 ounce Tettnanger hops and 1 ounce traditional German hop. We're gonna use one of these clarifier tablets, the Werflock tablet, and we're gonna crush it. Crushing tablet. Okay, tablet crushed, next. Some yeast additive. We're gonna use a half a teaspoon, and I like to think of this as the vitamins and minerals that the yeast would like to have. So there you go. It's a powder as well. All right, let's go check the steeping grain. Okay, it's been 30 minutes, I think. Oop. It's a little less than 155, but we're gonna take that bag out now. So I'm gonna pull this out and suspend it over this set of oversized barbecue tongs to let it drip. And I'm not gonna squeeze it out. There we go. Not sure about the not squeezing it out. I think it's probably because it might make it bitter or something. So we'll let that drip for a couple minutes. Okay, heat back on, and we're gonna bring it to a rolling boil. Okay, just to double check the recipe and the German traditional pellets, we're going to boil for 60 minutes and the Tettnager for 20 minutes. Okay, going to get rid of the steeping grains. So check the temperature. We're at almost 180. You can see the color is more beer-like and has a really pleasant smell. Okay. Looks like we've got a rolling boil. I'm gonna add the hop additions, but I'm gonna be very careful because I don't want it to boil over. Okay, I'm gonna add the additions and the hop additions. I'm gonna add everything. The clarifier, the nutrients, so like minerals. And then here's the first hops. These ones are going in for 60 minutes. So I'm gonna turn the heat back on and I'm gonna stir it. I just don't want it to boil over. Alexa, set a timer for 60 minutes.
1 hour, starting now.
Yeah, the second hop addition doesn't go in until 20 minutes before we turn the flame off. So 40 minutes from now. So I'll set another second timer for 40 minutes. Then we'll add that hop addition then. What's up there, Oliver? What's going on? So while this guy is boiling, I'm just gonna turn down the temperature a little bit to keep it going. I don't want it to boil over. Okay, next we're gonna sanitize the fermenter or the carboy. Okay, and we're gonna add a cap full of this IoStar iodine solution while we're filling it. There we go. We're gonna fill it up with the full 5 gallons so it can sterilize the whole carboy. Okay, so that 5 gallons of water with iodine has been sitting there for a minute or so. What we're gonna do is we're gonna siphon it down here into the bucket with our funnel, the wine thief, the hydrometer, the airlock, the tubing, and the auto siphon, all that. So we're gonna take the auto siphon, put that in, and attach the tubing next. Okay, we've attached the auto siphon to the tubing. Tubing is gonna go down into the bucket. Let's get that started. Okay, I'm gonna give the auto siphon a couple pumps and that'll get the water flowing. Okay, there we go. We got the sanitizing solution going into the bucket now. Now I'm also gonna get some of that solution and put it in here so I can sterilize the scissors and the stirring spoon. I'm just using an old Oktoberfest mug. There we go. Now I have a nice place where I can put small items to sterilize them. I'm actually gonna drop the yeast packet in there because I want that to be, you know, sterilized. I don't wanna get it contaminated. So I'm just gonna kind of leave it in there. Okay, we've been boiling for 40 minutes. So there's 20 minutes left in our boil. We're gonna add the second hop addition. And I'm just gonna be careful this thing doesn't boil over. I got the heat a little bit lower, so hopefully that'll help. All right, so in 5 more minutes, we're gonna add the DME or the dried malt extract. Okay, so all this stuff is pretty much sterilized. I've got some foil. Also sterilized, and I'm just gonna cover the carboy. Now all this sanitizing fluid I have, I'm actually gonna put in the cooler over there. Okay, we're gonna temporarily turn off the heat, and we're gonna add the malt extract next, right here. So what I'm gonna do is gonna basically slowly add this and then stir it with the spoon. And I'm just gonna keep stirring that and slowly adding it until it all dissolves, all 6 pounds of it. There we go, so 6 pounds of that all stirred in. Gonna let that come to a boil again, and then I'll finish the timer off with 15 minutes left. Okay, gonna assemble the wine thief and get the hydrometer ready. Okay, gonna put some water in the cooler. Okay, we've got a rolling boil starting, so we're just gonna turn down the temperature and continue for the last 15 minutes. Okay, it's been a full hour. Gonna turn off the heat. Okay, next we're gonna transfer this 20 liter pot to this water and start cooling it down. So I'm gonna watch the thermometer, stir the water, and swap out some of the water for cooler water. Once it gets to about 150 degrees, then I'll add ice. Okay, I've been stirring the water, moving around. We're down to about 150. I'm gonna put the lid on there because we're getting into the danger. Okay, I got rid most of the warm or hot water. I'm gonna add this sterilized cooler water and ice. Now, what I'm gonna do with the stopper is I'm gonna assemble it, and then I'm gonna put it in this this stein right here with the sanitized solution. There we go. We're just gonna leave it here inside the sanitizing solution. Okay, pot's moved back into the water that's cooler. It's also the sanitized water. Now I'm just putting every single ice pack we have all around it to see if we can cool this down to about 90 degrees. Okay, I found a lid that fit a little tighter, and same kind of deal. I got the ice packs all around. I'm kind of just kind of moving their water around and getting that temperature lower. Okay, we finally got down to 90 degrees, so we're gonna transfer this to the carboy. So you have to be careful with the carboy because it is wet and you wouldn't wanna drop it. But I've got the sanitized funnel on top, and I'm just gonna simply pour the solution into here. Let's do it. There it goes. So there you go. Most everything is poured in. And it's about half full because we're about to add cold water. And I didn't pour all the muck that's down there.
Okay, cold water's going in until we have 5 gallons total. So there it goes.
Okay, next I'm gonna aerate this for about 5 minutes. So we're just gonna swish this around like this and get lots of oxygen into it. Okay, next we're gonna use the Wine Thief to get some of the beer and fill this hydrometer and take a hydrometer reading. We're taking our hydrometer reading. It's about 105.0, 105.2. Okay, and we take good notes of what the reading was before. Okay, next thing we're gonna do is we're going to pitch the yeast. So we're going to open this package. There's an inner package, and we're going to pour it right in that carboy. Okay, so we're not messing around. We're using sterilized scissors. That's the sterilization solution. And here's the inner packet. We're going to cut that next. Okay, the yeast is in. I just poured it in, and I'm going to put the stopper on here next. Not to get sidetracked, but I am going to try the beer before it gets fermented. Okay, I got my sanitized airlock ready to go. And we are putting that guy on there. There we go. Okay, so next step is I'm gonna take this cooler and put it in its resting place in the house where it's gonna be cool. And we're gonna put the carboy inside of it, and I'm gonna probably rotate in and out four frozen water bottles each morning and each evening to try to keep this between 50 and 60 degrees that a lager would expect. Here you can kind of see it's settled down a little bit. Okay, so while the carboy is in this cooler with my water bottle or frozen water bottles rotating in and out, I don't want the lid to inadvertently hit this stopper here. So I just duct taped a coat hanger in so it won't move. And the last step is I cover the whole thing with a moving box, and then I check the temperature every morning and every evening.